going to stop for me. Let's try.
Hi, I'm Pooja Kothari. I'm 25. I'm a practicing architect from Bangalore, and you are watching A Day in My Life. So this is a client call, and it starts early by 9 o'clock and ends late by around 10 in the night. And not just client calls, but also vendor calls that we keep getting. I mean, it can start as early as 8 o'clock or 6 o'clock also if material has to be loaded on site. So typically, my day starts at 6, irrespective of calls, and ends by 11-ish. It would have been much more difficult for me to work as an architect and do house chores. Thank God that I'm living with my parents, and they're very supportive. Much of the things are already ready, and I just have to give a helping hand.
आपको दिन फोन अटेंड करती है जरूर कोई कम रात लगाओ को नहीं लेकिन टाइम मिले जरूर कम जरूर करें.
So I don't have my breakfast now. It's just my mom and the rest of my family. But I'll be having it a little later because I have some other work to do. I need to get to my desktop, and then the end would be my breakfast.
I'm running a little late today, and I need to start working. So here's how I prefer my desk to be. I like it with the view of the trees, so that when I'm working, I'm in a calm state, and I think my output is better this way. I have a few works to do before I visit the site, because the whole day I'm going to be out on site. I thought I'll just finish some, and it's not a burden in the night. But there are other works sometimes when I have to sit completely on designing, and I am not off the seat for nearly 10 hours also.
Architects don't do the working drawings. They usually have interns and junior architects working with them who do all this, but since I'm a freelance architect, I'll have to do this on my own.
So I'll be putting the file on render now, and I'll carry on with getting ready for the site visits.
Walking towards the metro station, I visit my site however far, at least twice or thrice a week, and that helps me keep a track of what work is going on the site. And usually there are a lot of vendor disputes that we need to handle so that the work is running smoothly and there are no delays in the end result.
Despite all the crowd, metro is worth it, because even if I'm getting late, I know I have an assurance that I can get there in an hour.
Difficult to get in the Canada by the for a matter that even if I'm asking for 10 autos, no, all 10 will reject, and I might not even get an Uber or Ola for that period.
So it's almost a 30-minute waste if I haven't planned that far ahead.
One eternity later.
He wants me to pay double. No meters. Finally got an auto. So you see how difficult it was for me to get an auto. I've asked around 10-15 auto guys, and I've tried Uber for the last 15 minutes, and then finally I'm getting an auto. So yeah, I'm heading to my destination, which will be about 30 minutes from now. And let's see you at the site. So yeah, today is a surprise visit, and we are just checking what execution work has happened. We haven't informed the vendor, so let's see what's going on. Usually what happens is when you come informed, they are all prepared, ready with neat and clean work done.
But when we come suddenly, we really get to know what's happening inside. So that's what we are going to check now.
I've been hearing an excuse for the last 2 days that the work isn't happening, like we were supposed to be laying marble, but the project head on board didn't get material cleared from his side and kept blaming it that other vendors haven't cleared it. So when we come and see, the reality is the other vendors have cleared it and it was his fault. Much of the time is consumed into execution, where you need to keep inspecting, you need to keep making the vendors and the laborers understand. You have to get down to their language to make them understand that this is how you are supposed to be doing XYZ work. So those tasks are a little tedious. It's hard to catch up with the laborers and get them to do work on time. So I think much of my time, energy and mental energy is also consumed in the execution stage as compared to design stage. In the end, I'm sure client will not know what has gone wrong. We are the ones who need to check up and keep reporting as to this is the issue. It's very horrifying. So on a surprise visit, I get to see what went wrong.
So I'm done with the site visit here, and pretty much covered whatever was there in the scope for now. Now I'm heading to another site. It's a renovation based project, so it's a new client, so we'll be going to meet her and let's see how it goes with her. I met her in a workshop, art workshop. And that's how we got connected. She plans to remodel her studio, which is an art studio. So since my architecture firm stands with the theme art meets architecture, I think this is the perfect example where I could really show that out. We had a nice discussion of how we could display and merge both of the elements, art and architecture. And let's see. We're looking at discussing all the finances in another 2 days and freezing on the project. So now we'll be heading to another site, which is about an hour from here. That is a renovation project. So let's see what happens on the next site. Okay, so now I'll be heading back home. This was site 3, which is done for the day. Too tired for the day, just wanna reach home.
Just had some coffees to energize, or else I was totally dead. Like you see, it's the peak of period. I'm just trying to struggle and stand here. Please give me some space.
Walking back home, it's a 10-minute walk from metro station. This is the hardest to pull off for me in the end of the day, although I'm close to wrapping up and reaching home, but so exhausted that it just takes me a little extra mental effort to pull off, and such horns are very disturbing at this state of mind. Although it was a very packed day, I had 3 site visits. Still reaching a little earlier when compared to the days when we have vendor visits. Vendor visits basically happen when we need to go to do selections with the client. Marble selection, tile selection, light selection. We try to club up a few which are close by, because it generally happens in the outskirts and it's hard to travel multiple times for that. So vendor visits day, I usually get back by 9:30. It's very worrying and concerning for my family. I get multiple calls. Also, so far my clients have been very human to me, and they tried to drop me to the safest point from where I could easily get a commute, whether a metro station or an auto.
So there have been times when my clients have just got up and said that give me the design tomorrow. It really doesn't work like that. We need to put in a lot of effort to design the space they would live in, because they are essentially going to stay there for a lot of time through their life, making good memories. So if it was just a design that could come in a day, then it wasn't even my job at the first place. So I personally take time to design, because I make sure I've made multiple site visits. I've understood the site. I've made multiple client visits. I've understood the client, and only then both merge and give an output. The output is a good design, which is going to be ideal for them for all their life, and they don't have to curse me ever for a bad design. But nevertheless, since I get to learn every day, since I get to do new things every day, I'm enjoying my work and I'm going. I don't think I would ever want to stop doing what I'm doing. Also, a lot of encouragement from my family, friends helped me grow and take this forward. Since you have already seen my whole day, I am sure you would have got some hints of the struggles that I face. Just to point out a few, generally when I'm visiting the site, since this is a male-dominated industry, it's quite uncomfortable when I go to sites and see 15 men around me, not one known. And secondly, my commute usually is in the peak hours, because I need to get to the place on time, as laborers also have a fixed time of working. So it just gets very claustrophobic and tiring because of the crowd. Sometimes no space to even stand. Third thing is that it's a little hard to sometimes balance personal life, home, and the professional when days get so busy. I'm almost not able to give any time to my family. I've reached home. Now I'm just waiting to have delicious yummy food cooked by mom, because I've been hungry all day. So after my food, I'll probably just note down a few minutes of the meeting, note down my tasks, plan off my day tomorrow, else it's just going to go all haphazard. Because if I don't plan and inform my vendors today, the day tomorrow is just going to be all confused and jumbled and haphazard. So yeah, I'm just going, eating yummy food, planning, and then sleeping. Bye!